Okay, so welcome to the heart of the Stockholm data center industry. This is Pionen. This facility was originally built during the Cold War to protect us from the Russians, mostly. Today we have converted it to a data center, and it's located under the data center itself is located about 30 meters below solid bedrock. And this is the power supplies. This is diesel engines for redundancy, and they provide power for cooling and for all the servers and the facility. And it's double. And also originally they are made or built for submarines. So this is old submarines engines. So we have some small details for that. This is the alarm horn. And it's originally a German U-boat horn, actually. But it's just like kind of a detail. It doesn't have that importance. Like otherwise, then it's just a detail. But come in. And since we are located underground, we have put some emphasis to have a nice working environment. There is no windows in here, so we have to try to get this as nice and organic for humans as possible. So that's why we have these plants. And of course, the ideas, what we are seeing here, is also inspired by science fiction movies and James Bond and stuff like that. There's no practical reasons for that sense, but it's a nice touch. If you work in a facility like this, you have to have a good working climate. So this is why we used, it's better for the air also. Come in here in the airlock. Data center. And it's built on, it's about 120 racks, cabinets located here. And it's mostly high profile customers, companies using co-location, and there are also a lot of cloud services. And up here, it's conference room based on glass, which we have above, and it's also 30 meters above us is the surface. So now we are standing at the deepest point. And this here, this box here, just for interest, it's not online since a couple of years ago, but this is the original, the primary server for WikiLeaks. It's not online now, but they used to be a customer. And this is the server that was all the fuss about by that time. We have kept it. This is a fire extinguishing system. The air is analyzed, and this is containing for in case of fire. And this is the warmth. When you stand there, you really feel how warm it gets in the data center. All this energy puts into the server. This is the warm side. You feel this energy coming out of all the machines. It's really hot. And this also, I'm going to talk something about the heat, because right now all this heat, all these servers, all these boxes standing here, they use a lot of energy. And this is a traditional data center in the sense that we use what you call leveled floor. The cool air is coming up here and cooling the boxes inside. So we use leveled floor here. And the next thing is, I think we're gonna go up to the conference room. I think we start here. And this was before, it was an airlock here where you had this extra door. We had removed that, but this was kind of, there was a shower here where you have a shower to remove radioactive dust and biological stuff and like that before you entered into the facility. So we have some of the old stuff is left from the Cold War. This looks mainly like any other network operation center. this is some of our guys working here for monitoring our network and working with technical support and stuff. This is one of our data centers in Stockholm, so not everybody's working here, but this is the main core for checking the network and working with the servers. And up here, this room was used originally when we took over this facility. There were beds here and sleeping facility. Nowadays they have turned it into our kitchen room, and we have this fish tank. I was going to have piranha fishes in it from the start, but they. Piranha fishes, they are kind of brownish and don't look so nice, so kind of boring, so we have just used saltwater fishes with colorful. It also has, except for the design purpose, it has a purpose of having stuff like makes it more enjoyable to work deep below the ground. So this is our part of our technical company, technical support. And also here we are using plants, all the walls are covered with plants, and that's to make it more enjoyable to work here. Yes? Let me take you to the conference room here. So this is our meeting room, and now we are standing in this kind of a core of the facility, hovering above the servers and the data center. And when we were in the data center, you noticed that there's a lot of heat. All these machines generate heat. And the business idea that we have, which is unique, there's nobody had done that in a large scale before in the world, is to use that excess heat and put it into facilities to heat up households. So we use the energy, put it in the district heating system, reuse the energy, so the energy can be used twice. If you think about it, a data center is more or less like a big radiator. It's an element which generates heat. And if you have something that generates heat, it's a stupid idea to just ventilate it out in thin air. The normal idea with data centers before has been to use what you call free cooling. And then if you have a cold climate, let's ventilate out the heat in the cold air. That is dumb, because what you do is you use all the energy and you just ventilate it out when it could have been used to put into facilities and companies and heating up large residential areas. Basically, you reuse the energy twice. And that is not possible to do in all places in the world. But if you have a densely populated area and if you have a cold climate, then you can do that. So it's a good business model, and it's also very good for the environment. So that makes Stockholm unique. And all our data centers, we have now three major data centers in Stockholm City, and all those are connected to the district heating system, and they warm up all the residential areas.